Tim Kirkton joins us now on SportsCenter from Cuba. And Tim, so much of life is about context and perspective. And I wonder what you have gained in your short time there that is perhaps different from what you might have anticipated.
Well, the one thing that struck me today, Scott, I went on a tour of Havana with Chris Archer and a couple of other Rays, and we went to a place called the Hot Corner, which is like a park in the middle of the city. And it's renowned for, there's just a bunch of guys in there that sit around talking about baseball all day. And when we arrived with Chris Archer and Steven Souza Jr. and Loney, we had a great time, and all of a sudden we were just completely engulfed by these people who wanted to talk baseball. Now, I know this kind of stuff goes on all over the world, but there's a special place here where it's, you know, the Hot Corner. That's where you go to talk baseball. I was really struck by that today. Just another reminder of how much the people here love baseball.
Tim, what I don't remember, and I'm embarrassed to admit this, but I don't remember the Orioles in 99. And what can you tell me about that time as opposed to this time, just in terms of just obviously the climate's different, but I mean, just what these guys are getting out of it and what maybe the Oriole team in 99 did? Because I frankly don't, I have no perspective there.
Well, I think the Orioles got something out of it, certainly. But what has also struck me is how interested the Rays are as an organization to going to Cuba. And maybe, like you said, it's just the climate. But the guys I went with today were, this is so much more than a baseball trip for them. And I think it's just as much as a bunch more enlightened players today, players that are engaged in how the world works much more now than 17 years ago. Because again, the guys I were with today, they were taking pictures. James Loney was all over the place. He wanted to know all about Cuba. He knew a lot about Cuba. And this is rare for baseball players to be this involved. And my guess is the Rays are much more into this than perhaps the Orioles were 17 years ago.
It's clear that this is a big deal back in the States, and for us, obviously, we look forward to seeing the game and what have you. But just there, how is it playing? I mean, I get it in the Hot Corner. They were excited to see players and you, I'm sure. But just how big a deal do you get a sense that it is in Cuba?
Well, it's huge here, Scott. As you know, the World Baseball Classic is all that the people of Cuba have to look forward to certain years. Like, this is it. This is our World Series, is the WBC. The people here love baseball so much. And I was also struck today, Scott, when talking to some people, that there are no fields around here for the kids to play. And they're learning how to play, and they're playing in sandlots, they're playing on the street. That there's no place for them to play, and yet they've become really, really good at it, perhaps because they're learning how to play not on a really manicured field. They're playing in places they shouldn't even be playing. But the bottom line here is how much these people love baseball. I think we'll see it at the ballpark tomorrow, but you have to wonder, are those the entitled people that are going, or are they the people that really, truly love the game? It may be a combination of both.
Tim, thanks as always for the time. Travel home safe. Look forward to talking to you soon.
Thank you, Scott.